Welcome to Le Castellet as we return from across the Atlantic for the 2018 French Grand Prix. The last time Formula One cars raced at the Circuit Paul Ricard, Alain Prost took Ferrari's 100th Grand Prix victory and the 42nd of his own illustrious career. That was 28 years ago, when half of the drivers on the grid today had yet to be born. And how, I wonder, will that legacy continue in the modern era? Mastering a lap of Paul Ricard means getting to know 15 corners, 6 left and 9 right, for an overall lap distance of 3.6 miles. The two halves of the long Mistral Strait are separated by a heavy braking zone into a potential overtaking hotspot at the Chicane Nord. And watch out for the drivers running onto the distinctive coloured stripes, which are low in grip and highly abrasive. With me today, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk about Davidson. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
They've been avoiding mistakes and had solid pace, so it's been a good season so far, but whether they can keep that up long term remains to be seen.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. Davidson lines up on pole position. Sergio Perez lines up alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Ricciardo, Hülkenberg, Max Verstappen, and Alonso, Ocon, Sainz, Bottas, and Lewis Hamilton, Grosjean, Leclerc, they've taken a grid penalty, Pierre Gasly, and Magnussen, Stroll, Vettel, Marcus Ericsson, and Brendan Hartley. Raikkonen and Sergei Sirotkin rounds off the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
This is our engine supplier's home Grand Prix. Let's give them a race worth watching. Okay, go through all the gears if you can. We need to make sure the engagement is okay before the start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres and brakes. We need to keep the engine cool though, so don't go too high with the revs. No threat of rain for the time being. Conditions looking good. The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. Thank you. That's a decent start. Good job. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the super softs. Okay, we're monitoring somewhere on the ICE. Be aware that we will start to see a loss of power. We're leading our teammate by 15.5 seconds. Power from the engine is going to be down slightly. It's showing some minor wear. box, box. We're coming in this lap. Box now, please. Box this lap. The gap to the car behind is 20.2 seconds. Go, go, go! That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Fernando's in for his stop. great work. That's a new fastest lap for the race. Good job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Okay, the incident has been cleared. Let's get back up to racing speed. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Fantastic. You've won the Grand Prix.
What a fantastic Grand Prix that was, and an excellent win for McLaren. Tell me, Ant, what was the key to this success?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs. And that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
And look at that, they're making their way out onto the podium now. Great race from the McLaren team, and I'm really happy to see them there on the top step of the podium. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the drivers' championship.